The first step in many protein analytical methods, including Western blot analysis, is to separate the proteins in a sample by gel electrophoresis. The most widely used protein electrophoretic technique is sodium dodecyl sulfate polyacrylamide gel electrophoresis, or SDS-PAGE, in which proteins are denatured and evenly charged by the ionic detergent SDS, so that the proteins migrate through the gel based only on size. Polyacrylamide gels can be poured in the lab by combining various concentrations of acrylamide and bisacrylamide with the cross-linker ammonium persulfate and TIMID, which catalyzes the polymerization reaction. Precast polyacrylamide gels are also available, with various acrylamide concentrations and gradients. Let's look at performing SDS-PAGE using HeLa cell lysates and precast gels. After adjusting protein levels so that all lysates have a uniform protein concentration, combine the lysates with a sample buffer that includes SDS, glycerol, a tracking dye such as bromophenol blue, and a reducing agent such as diethiothreatol, beta-mercaptoethanol, or TSEP. Heat the samples for 3 to 5 minutes to denature and reduce the proteins, and then cool them to room temperature. Place a gel into an electrophoresis unit, and fill the upper and lower buffer tanks of the unit with a running buffer made of Tris, Glycine, and SDS to enable proper flow of the electric current through the gel. Then load the protein samples into the wells in the gel. Because the glycerol in the loading buffer is heavier than the running buffer, the samples should easily drop to the bottom of their respective wells. The volume loaded into each well can range from 1 microliter to over 40 microliters, depending on the protein concentration, well size, and gel thickness. Also, load a separate well with a molecular weight marker to assess the relative molecular weight of the target protein. Once the samples and marker are loaded, connect the electrophoresis unit to a power source, making sure that the cables are correctly connected to ensure correct protein migration. Then apply an electric field at the appropriate voltage or current, which depends on the type and number of gels being used. Bubbles appearing around the cathode indicate that the current is flowing. Once the diffront reaches the bottom of the gel, turn the power off and unplug the cables from the power source. Remove the gel cassette from the electrophoresis unit and carefully separate the gel from the plates. The gel is now ready for Western blot, Kumasi stain, or another protein analytical method.